Drunk driving on a Wednesday with three bitches in the MPV. So it's We Sports Wednesday. You may have noticed that I have uploaded 2-3 We Sports Wednesdays this week. And why not? And so usually it's always a Nintendo-related vid. And 2K, it's not Nintendo-related, but it's a sports game. And you can play it on the Switch. So yeah, I could talk about it here. But today I wanted to talk about the most underrated 2K soundtrack, in my opinion, and one that is underappreciated by the 2K community. So when people talk about the best 2K soundtracks, games like 2K16 and 2K11 come into mind. And even though I always personally thought it was 2K14 that was the best soundtrack, the game I talk about is different. So in this year, the one that I talk about, 2K made the soundtrack a lot more upbeat than other years. And I mean, like, 2K16 was pretty dark sounding, and then 2K19, a future release, was, and then 2K19 was a future release, and it was packed with darkness. So it was not, there was upbeat songs in it, but a very few of them. But for this one, we got a lot of more happier, upbeat, daytime sounding music, and I'm talking about NBA 2K18, the greatest mix of old school rap, modern rap, and EDM. And the EDM on the soundtrack is fire. It's some of the best I ever heard, and I still listen to a lot of these songs nowadays. Also, considering this game released in 2017, and that was the year EDM wasn't completely shit, it was just partially pretty outstanding. So the vibe of this soundtrack is best because it's like uplifting, upbeat, and a happy sounding workout playlist. Like, out of all soundtracks I'll take with me to the gym, I'll take this one. Because 2K19 sounds too depressing, 2K20 sounds too boring. I didn't even get 2K17, so I don't know what that soundtrack sounds like. And 2K16 is for a workout at nighttime. So let's discuss some of the best songs in this soundtrack. Rolling Japanese till I flow. Rolling, I've been living like the goat. Now the first song I'm gonna talk about here is a special one because 2K actually remixed it, and the remix version was only to be found at 2K18. Until September 28, 2019, when it was released publicly. But someone else had to upload it, so. The remix version that 2K18 made uses a flute instead of the marine note. The regular U1 uses it. The 808s are a lot of distorted and moving around, and the drums have a lot more energy. This gon' last a minute, raise the bar up. You've been feeling really lonely, you a star. This gon' last a minute, raise the bar up. You've been feeling really lonely, you a star. The thing that both of them have in common is the synth, which is the best one I've ever heard and probably one of the best main melodies in 2K history. Only problem I have with the synth is that it makes the song sound outdated all the way back to 2017. It sounds like it was made to be a summer hit in 2017, and guess what? That's exactly what it was, looking at the release date, June 15, 2017. K1D did great on his verse, and Woody Smalls performs vocally well here. And it fits a lot into 2K18, and I can only envision it in 2K18. Also, I want to hear Woody Smalls in 2K21. The In Between Spaces album he put out March 20, 2020 was very good, and he's a really underrated artist. You should listen to it. And this one is an important song for me because it's the first Woody Smalls song I ever heard, and I'm a big fan of him now. And this is also my fourth most listened to song on Spotify of all time, and my most listened to song of summer 2019. So this is one of the theme songs of my life, basically. But let's get on to the next song. Swimming so deep in your water, vision blurred, vision blurred. We're going on to. So this is an EDM and R&B mashup, and it is the best EDM song I heard in my life, and the best song of the 2K18 soundtrack, in my opinion. So I need more music like this, R&B and EDM, or at least like trap and EDM. And this has one of the greatest 808s of all time. I can vibe to this in driving a car at 2 a.m. at night. This is also a remix version. The original is great too, and it has a nice vibe to it. And I can imagine the original version in Super Mario Galaxy. Like, it's a weird comparison, but I'm gonna show you that it isn't right now. Nintendo makes their own music, but if they did it like NBA 2K does it, this would definitely be a song of the soundtrack. The vocals on this track is amazing. I really thought it was Chris Brown at first, but then if you listen close enough, it's not him, because when I first heard it, it wasn't him. Chris Brown also fits the instrumental, and I kind of wish he was on it, so, because that would make it more popular. But also in May 2019, I made a fire mashup with the song. Giving to me, no time to play. Won't hesitate when I'm diving in. Swimming so deep in your water, vision blurry,
need some blood. We're going out to deep. Drowning for the weekend. I don't need a reason. Put it all on me. I see you creeping. You must be fiending. Don't worry, you gon' get the treatment. Put it all on me.
So I listened to this with bass boosted headphones. It was a great experience, and this is one of the most chill songs you'll ever hear. Like, listen to this with a city at night, skyline, and tell me that you are in love.
No, I don't run away as a savage. Yeah, I do it for no reason, that's just savage. I deserve something different than average. If you die for the weekend.
Exactly, so this is the best song on NBA 2K18 in my opinion. And I need to listen to more EDM and R&B mashups. So if you got any of the comments to recommend to me, please do so. And it better be chilled. The remix was originally uploaded by Chill Nation, so I might check out their stuff. But still recommend in the comments.
Some people got the real problems. Some people out of love. Some people think I can...
I'm not done talking about remixes. Human by Ragged Bone Man is also remixed. Not by 2K, but... The original song was great enough, like I loved it in 2016-17, but then the EDM vibe this gives, the horns they use, and the instrumentation fits well into 2K. I can see this on 2K20 as well, but it fits best on 2K18 with all the red things in the background moving around. And the singer is excellent here. The energy is great, the piano is used great, and this has some of the best instrumentation I've ever seen in the song. Also, the original version is great as well. It's just sad for the past three songs I mentioned, these remixes are all better. The thing with like 2K18 is that like all the songs sound like they were made in 2017. Deep End, Tokyo Drift, and this remix of Human, but in, well, they all sound like they were made in 2017. But you want to know it didn't?
They only make legends where I'm from. Been who we want before the song begun. And this feels like a victory.
This one, and also quick question. What do you all think is the most underrated song in the game? And what do you think is the most underrated 2K song of all time? I definitely had to answer with this one. Not of all time, but in 2K18 it definitely is. Because when I first heard this, I wasn't really familiar with Joey Badass's music. Now, I do listen to more of it now, and I thought this song was released in like 1996 or something. But apparently it released in 2017, which shocked me. Anyways, this has the best instrumental on 2K18. The beginning is made with basketball sounds at a gym, and this is what I want to hear at a high school basketball game. Clean, energetic, and the vibe is just right. Also, I got obsessed with this song at the end of 7th grade and summer of 2019. That just gave me memories from those periods of times. The trumpets are great here, and this sound is one of the best sounds in music history. And then for the second verse, the bassline goes super duper hard. So if you're playing basketball with your friends, play this song because it fits perfectly. And this is also my third most listened to song on Spotify, so this is just perfection.
Plaquette ou projet en physique, tout le monde veut savoir combien tu vends. Vos paroles c'était du vent, je pense plus au passé, j'ai pris les devants.
Now, I can't really criticize the lyrics because it's in French and I do not understand that language, but the synth used as the main melody is great. The instrumental is boss, and I can't understand what he's saying, but he's not playing around, like the way his flow is. And this is also my 9th most listened to song on Spotify. All of Me by Big Gigantic is EDM prime. So like, y'all heard Skywalker, it's on 2K19. This is the EDM version of that song. Anyways, for this song, the singer sings great and the intro is beautiful. The bassline is great and then the beat drop is one of the greatest things ever. And then when it calms down, very refreshing. And I can't ignore Logic's verse. That was also pretty fire. Back when Logic was good. So this one is a great song. The production here is beautiful. And this song also sounds a lot like Sorry by Justin Bieber, but like an Italian version and better. 2016, it was a pretty horrible year for music, but this is how the good stuff sounded that year. This is also my 84th most listened to song on Spotify.
I wrote my way up. When the world turned its back on me, I was up against the wall.
I wrote my way out. Alec Black kills the hook here, and everyone is great on the verses. This is also my former friend's favorite song on the soundtrack. Fits into 2K well, and the lyrics are very great. Everybody featured does their job, and nobody is bad. This is how all musical lives should sound like. Everybody gotta do good.
No lie, tell them never meant to. Feel your eyes, they all over me. Don't be shy, take control of me. It's the vibe, it's gonna be.
So if you haven't been watching my other music reviews, Dua Lipa is a perfect person who will never do anything wrong, and she does perfect things, and they're always perfect. She will never make a bad song, and everything she makes is 10 out of 10 or plus. Anything below that does not exist, because she's incapable of that. And this is her best song. It sounds outdated though, stuck in 2017, but that's always good, because 2017, even though it wasn't a good year for music, its style, the vibe it gave off, was definitely good. Sean Paul is good here, and my favorite part of this is that the instrumental sounds very summer, as I blasted this summer 2017, 18, and 19, and most likely 20. It's May 28 as I'm recording this, and I count summer as June 1 and onwards, but I'm most likely going to be blasting this during the summer. So this is the ideal summer song with the instrumentation, and we need more music like this.
Let's see if I know the ledge.
Know the Ledge is a song that should be on, like, I think there should be a list of songs that should be on every 2K game. Like, you got Little by Little from 2K11, and then Know the Ledge from 2K18. Yes, it should, because it reminds me of 90s basketball so much. Like, it gives you Michael Jordan, Hakeem Olajuwon, Patrick Ewing, Carl, Shaq, Barkley, Payton, all that. It gives you vibes of those. It's also very fast paced, so if I were to hear this on the court, I'll be playing like a god. And this bass line, I can't really identify as that's a piano or a guitar, but it's one of the most genius things I ever heard. And this is one of the most basketball sounding songs I ever heard. Let's talk about Kendrick Lamar. So this game released in 2017. My favorite artist of 2017 was Kendrick Lamar, and he's also probably the most popular artist that year. This has Kendrick in it, so it's perfect. Also, the vibe of the song is great. It fits more on 2K16 than 2K18, and 2K19 not really, but it's very chill. Listen to this with a city skyline again and be mesmerized. It's really a vibe song that you hear. Like, imagine hearing this on the Go Vacation radio. Like, some of you might not know this game, but I have a lot of Nintendo fans watching this, so they do.
I'm leading chill from 93
chill. Yeah, this is how we chill from 93.
So for 93 till infinity, I listened to this a lot in early 7th grade, and the hook is prime. This is lit. The melodies used in the song are placed just at the right spot, and the amount of rappers make it great. This reminds me of an old Discord server I was on in 2018. It still exists today, but it's pretty dead. This is the song of the squad. I'm not going to thoroughly explain these next songs though, but they are all worth mentioning. Shook Ones and Victory are both on NBA 2K13, so I won't be talking about them in this video. Yo Te Imagino Gata by Arcano proves rap and EDM are always a great combination, and this has a great 808 as well. Kinda Let It Fly is a 2K18 theme song and gives you 7th grade flashbacks. No You Don't is really the 2K18 theme song, which is a stretch. But if 2K18 would have a theme song, I'm pretty sure this would be one of them. Humble was number 4 in 2017's year end. Everybody knows that song and why it's good, so yo, I'm not gonna sit here. Usher's guitars are great, and I love when 2K switches up the genre. They need to have variety in their playlist. Fever is very energetic and infectious. Nas Is Like is one of the best songs I ever heard. Don't Threaten Me With a Good Time is very lit. I play it at a party. Stand Back is great, and both the artists performs great in the beat. So Fresh So Clean actually makes me feel clean. Listen to that, instead of taking a shower, you smell good. Feel So Good has one of the greatest song intros of all time. And for coming out strong,
the only time I feel alive when I taste it.
And also Can't Have by Pitbull. I forgot to include that song in the script, but I'm gonna mention it right now. Anyways, 2K18 is my favorite soundtrack, but it's my second favorite 2K soundtrack for sure. And I'd put it above NBA 2K16 soundtrack without hesitation. And that's saying something, because 2K16 soundtrack is pretty fire. Goodbye, join the Discord, and have a stellar day.